You want to watch what I have in store for you next? Stick around.
She wants a hummingbird feeder out on the deck railing, so we found this at the store, and it clamps down at the bottom, comes up here at an angle, and then we're gonna hang it off of that. That's kind of slick. I'll probably end up making a video of that. Then we got some little hooks from the store, like that, so we can hang off a tree branch and then hang a bird feeder off of there. She likes bird feeders because she likes to see the birds. It's amazing all the types of birds that show up once you put a bird feeder up, or you put this, you get this other stuff called what is it called? I just had the name. It's suet. Before I met Momi, I didn't even know what suet was. It's little cakes, and the birds peck on that. You get woodpeckers and all kinds of stuff. But anyways, they left some stuff here. This is tile grout and some tile, and in the other garage, they've got all kinds of paint and stuff. That was kind of good. You know, the painter, we talked to the painter, he's even gonna paint the garages for us. And eventually, this floor, check this out, there's a drain in the garage floor. That's kind of cool. So that you can rinse this out, and they just decided to put a drain, you know. But anyways, we're gonna have the floors clean, and we'll probably put that epoxy stuff down. And I think I'm gonna have a company do that. You can get that paint at the store and the flakes and stuff and do it yourself. But you know, I'm gonna have a professional company over here, and I think I'm gonna video the whole thing so that you guys can see how they do that. They put these spike things on their feet so they walk around without messing up the floor. It's this epoxy stuff. They have to clean the floor, then they have to put the primer down, then they have to put the two coats of this paint, put the flakes down there, and then they put sealer coats over that. They do all kinds of junk. Okay, anyways. I'm still kind of getting my bearings here on what's gonna happen and what I'm gonna have to do here. I thought this was kind of slick. The alarm company, you see that right there? That's a smoke alarm. And the alarm company, they put that one up. Now here's our existing smoke alarm. And I was like, why can't you just put it there? Well, we're having this monitored 24 hours a day for smoke in the house. You put one upstairs, we've got one downstairs, and then carbon monoxide little doohickeys. In fact, I think they installed one down here. Let's see what it looks like anyways. Anyways, that's gonna be monitored, so if anything goes off, like if we're sleeping or something and it goes off in the middle of the night, the security company can call us. There it is, right there. See, that's a carbon monoxide device. Because we got gas stoves. There's a gas stove here. And so if your gas ever leaks, if your gas line ever leaks, and I'm not sure, I think that's a washing machine. Washing machine. I was gonna say dishwasher, but the dishwasher's over there. Anyways, this, I think this is electric. I don't think it's gas. But if your gas ever happens to leak, goes along the floor, this could pick it up, and it will notify people. But anyways, back to the smoke alarms. Even the smoke alarms throughout the house, I looked at those, and this house, like I was saying, is 17 years old. See, here's an old style smoke alarm. And you might say, Joe, just replace the battery when it gets old. Maybe the batteries have already been replaced. Well, wrong. They have not replaced these smoke alarms since they built this house. House is, I think, 17 years old. And smoke alarms, believe it or not, the manufacturer, if you look on manufacturers' suggested comments or manufacturers' what they say to do with smoke alarms, they say you need to replace the entire smoke alarm after 10 years so that you know They're all updated. They're going to work properly and all that kind of stuff. And my thought is the same thing. If the if it stated that on a manufacturer, why on earth would you want these on here for longer than that? See that? See the green light? We know that's working. Anyways, I'm pretty much 100% sure that these are not just battery backups or battery only. This is probably hooked up to the house on an electrical circuit. And so I've got to get some smoke alarms for both battery backup and hardwired. And I'm going to get the type that have a 10-year battery, lithium battery, that's built into the smoke alarms. So you don't have to replace the 9-volt battery every 6 months or every year. Okay, they have those at the store, yeah. And I'm gonna get those and I'll show you all about that. In fact, I even have a video that shows all that kind of stuff now that I did for my mother's place. Well, I'm gonna make another video because this is different. And who knows, I might say something on this video that I didn't say exactly on the other videos that I made concerning smoke alarms. But anyways, back to the smoke alarms. Every 10 years, you've gotta replace those. So when I take these off, when I put the new smoke alarm up there, I'm gonna actually write on it, on a felt tip pin on the side of it somewhere. There's usually a little tag. Now these old ones, I don't think there are a tag, and I'm gonna write down the day that I installed it, so I know in 10 years that it has to be replaced, or somebody else will know when they need to be replaced. Because if you have a fire, and if your smoke alarm is older than 10 years, believe it or not, your insurance company comes out here, they might say, hey, we're only gonna cover so much of the fires because your smoke alarms are older than 10 years and maybe they find out that some of the smoke alarms weren't working properly because they're 10 years old, beyond 10 years, and maybe they don't cover your fire. So it's better to be safe than sorry. That's why I'm gonna replace all of these smoke alarms. Now, smoke detectors, and that's funny. See this room here, you would think there should be one here, right? Well, there's not. And the reason why there's not in this room, do you know why? Because this is not a bedroom. This is an office, and it's considered an office. If you were to sell this house and list it, you can't list this as a bedroom. And the reason why is because there's no closet. Well, if you look in a room and there's no closet, they cannot list that as a bedroom. You'd have to actually, if you wanted to show this as a bedroom, if you bought this house and you wanted to resell it, you could put a closet over there. If you put a small closet or all the way across or something halfway and boom over or something, you can then call this room a bedroom. Did you know that? And then you might get more for your house if you list it as a 4-bedroom instead of 3-bedroom or something like that. Okay. So anyways, smoke alarms throughout, I've already counted those up and I'll end up doing something else. See all these eyeball lights, all these can lights, they're really cool, but all of them are probably 60-watt bulbs. So I'm gonna look up there one of these days when I don't have anything to do. And I'm gonna see if that's the case, because my guess is every single one of these light bulbs is probably 60 watts, or they could even be 75s because they're floods. See how big they are? So I'll have to take those down, look at them, and then make a decision. Okay, can I get 40? I could put 40-watt bulbs in there. I could put a compact fluorescent type of bulb in there, or an LED style bulb that kind of looks like a light as big as these, you know, and save all kinds of electricity. And LEDs, those might be, you know, 6 to 8 watts each, as opposed to 60 watts each. Look at all these. If I turn the light switch on, you probably go out there to the electrical panel and you probably see the thing whizzing around because you've got all of this wattage on with these lights. So that's probably something I'll do later. Let's check all that stuff out. And together we'll figure out that kind of stuff. And you'll be right along with me on what I decide, and then maybe, you know, you can do the same thing at your house. That's why I'm making all these videos, by the way, because it might have something to do with you and what you're doing and how to go about fixing it, okay? So, anyways, I think I'm gonna cut this video short. Yeah, we've got downstairs too.
And see all the ripples in the carpet? We're going to have those fixed. We've got a guy coming out here to do that, incidentally. We looked at the
carpets. I'll make a separate video of that. But that's something that we looked at that we wanted to have fixed before we moved in. And it's probably something you might want to do yourselves before you move into a place. Look at the carpets, see if they need to be clean. And by the way, we did clean these carpets, and these carpets actually held up pretty good. See the type of carpet it is? It's cut pile here. And I thought there was some level loop in here too, but I don't know. Most of it is cut pile. Cut pile means instead of a loop that kind of goes like that across, they've cut the top of it. That's why they call it cut pile. Because it's all cut, but it's actually held up pretty good. And eventually we'll replace it, but we ended up having the carpet cleaners come out here. And this type of carpet, look at all these impressions in the carpet. That's the one thing I wasn't really too happy about. But whenever you've got furniture, you've seen it lots of times in your carpet, that like if you've moved something, you see all this stuff. Well, this stuff, I know that lots of this is going to have, I'm going to have to take some special attention to this. And when I talked to the carpet guy, he looked at it and he says, oh, I got a trick for that. And I'm hoping he's going to let me video what that trick is, or maybe he can explain it to me and I can do some of these. But I'm not going to even touch these until we get all the furniture in here, get the beds in here, get the desk in here and all that kind of stuff. Because see all the dots here? Once we put the furniture up here, obviously the new furniture is going to create new holes, but you're not going to see those, the impressions. And lots of the furniture is going to cover lots of these impressions. So maybe we've only got, you know, these two impressions here and this one out here and that one to the far side. Maybe those are the only ones that I have to take care of. I don't know. But anyways, all the carpet, see there's a little bit of this here. It looks like the carpet is slightly dirty, but that's just from wear, and that's from the sun. Because when the sun comes in here, see there's some sun bleached areas here. See this little spot right here? They had a little ottoman there or something. See that? Looks like it's dirty, but it's not. That's from the sun. We've got another one right here. But we've got a chair coming, and we're probably gonna have to strategically locate it over that, maybe a table or maybe another little chair there or something. So there's different things we're gonna have to do. But anyways, we talked to the carpet guy, and he's gonna stretch some different areas for us and fix like those steps going downstairs. And he suggested to get the carpet cleaners here first, so that this carpet can now start relaxing. The painter's going to be here in about a week and a half, well, a week actually, at the end of this week. And so the carpet's going to kind of relax for maybe 3 weeks before the carpet guy gets here. And we ended up, for that reason alone, we had the carpet cleaners come first, then the carpet guy's going to come and stretch all the carpets in certain areas afterwards. And now we can see what the carpets look like and the type of cleaning we took. I was just going to have a regular carpet cleaner come out here, and then the carpet guy says, oh no, don't do that, use like ChemDry. ChemDry is a company that they clean their carpets, and they use 80% less water on the carpet, and it gets it just as clean. And I'm not quite sure how that all works, but we contacted a lady from ChemDry. She came out here. These carpets aren't going to look any cleaner than this had we done it a different way. 80% less water was used on these carpets, which makes the carpet pad not get wet. It sucks everything up out of there instead of forces some of the dirt down into the carpet more so than not. And it also prolongs the life of the carpet, I guess. So you might want to, next time before you clean your carpets, you might want to check with somebody. Talk to someone of the ChemDry, talk to them, and then talk to a regular company that does it with water, you know, 100% with water, and make the choice yourself. And depending on your carpet condition and how long you're going to stay there and blah, 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 you know, all that kind of stuff. Get all the information before you have to decide what to do with your carpet.